Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this lecture of Python, we'll learn certain advanced loops programs. Like for example, we'll learn how to find out the sum of n sequence numbers, find out the maximum value out of certain entered values, printing of random numbers between a specific range, entering a number and finding out whether it is a prime number or not, and printing the prime number between two ranges. So these are certain advanced programs connected with the loop. Obviously, it requires the nesting of loops also.
In this question, we'll be learning how to display the prime numbers. See, these are prime numbers between 1 and 100. Not only this, we'll be learning how to display n sequence numbers, that is the limit will be entered by the user. We'll be learning how to display the sum of sequence numbers, finding the smallest value among n numbers. These are all the questions, random numbers and all. So please watch the video up till the end. Let us start. So this is the second lecture of for loops. I assume that you already seen my earlier lecture of loops, where we've seen all the programs related to while loop and for loop. Printing of even numbers, printing of odd numbers, printing in reverse sequence numbers, break and continue. So we'll start with this lecture now. So what is the first program that we'll do? We learn to print the n sequence numbers. That is, the limit will be entered by the user. Okay. So what we are doing that, we'll ask the user to enter the limit. Obviously, we'll be making use of input method. And we know that the value entered by input will be in the string format. So this input is nested inside this int method, which will do typecasting. It will convert the string into the integer format, and the value after converted into integer format will be assigned to this limit variable. So what is this program doing? Suppose the user enters the limit as 10. So it will display the sequence numbers from 1 to 10. And if the user enters the limit as 500, it will display the sequence number from 1 to 500. Okay. So let's see, suppose the user has entered the limit as 10. 10 will be assigned to this limit variable. For loop is there. Range method will go from 1 to limit plus 1. See, in this range, the right hand side portion is exclusive. That means it is never included. The range will terminate on reaching this value. Okay. So if the user has entered value 10, we want the loop to run up till 10. So we are entering the limit plus 1, that is 11. So that the for loop will terminate at the value 11. So it will run up to 10. Okay. So this plus 1 is very essential. Okay. And this nesting, we already have seen that this confirms the Python that this is the part of the for loop. Suppose the user enter value 10. The loop will go from 1 to 11. The value of I will be 1, 2, up till 10. Let's run this. Copy it. Paste it here. And let's run this. It is asking you to enter the limit. Suppose I enter the limit as 10. See, the limit has gone from 1 to 10, the sequence number. If I run it again, suppose I enter the limit as 500. See, this is the sequence number from 1 to up till 500. Okay. So the program is working perfectly well, right? And what is the next program? See, the question is that it will print the sum of n sequence numbers. Suppose user enters values 10. So what will happen that 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus up till 10, summation of the values from 1 till 10 will be displayed. Now what is the reason behind doing this question? See, the question which is usually asked in the exam is to find the factorial of an input number. Right. Here I am doing sum. In factorial what we are required is that suppose you enter value 5. So you want not the sum from 1 to 5, you want the multiplication of 1 to 5. So if you happen to understand this program, obviously you can convert this program into the factorial also. This is the homework for you. Okay. Now let's see what is this program doing. Before understanding it, I'll just run it first. It is asking you to enter the limit. Suppose I enter the limit as 5. Sum of sequence number up till 5 is 15. How it has come? Let me explain you through a example. See, this is the program here. You entered the limit as 5. That value 5 will be assigned to this num variable. Okay. Sum is the variable where you will be adding the addition of from 1 to 5. You will add 1, then you will add the value 2 to some variable, then you will add the value 3, 4 and 5. So all the summation of 1 till 5 will be in some variable. So this sum variable is initialized to 0. This is 0. Okay. For loop will go from 1 till 6. This is exclusive. So the loop will go from 1 to 5. The value of I is 1. So what will happen in this for loop? You are running this formula. The total of right hand side is assigned to left hand side. The value of sum is 0. The value of I is 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. And this 1 is assigned to this sum variable. So sum has become 1. For loop is over because no step is defined. So default step is 1. So the value of I will increment from 1, it will become 2. Okay. The control will go inside it. The result of this right hand side expression is assigned to the left. Sum plus I. Sum is 1. I is 2. 1 plus 2 is how much? 3. That will be assigned to the variable on the left. That is to the sum variable. So sum will become 3. The value of I will increment to 3. It will come over here. 3 plus 3. Can you see this? The addition of these 3 plus 3 will be assigned to this sum variable. I will increment to 4. Sum has become 6. 6 plus 4 is how much? 10. 10 will be assigned to this sum variable. The value of I will be incremented to 5. 10 plus 5 is how much? 15. And this 15 is assigned to sum variable. After that, the value of I will become 6, which is not allowed. Sum of sequence number up till percent D. The moment control will see percent D, that is the format specifier, control will go outside and the variable of this num variable will be placed at the place of this percent D. This percent D will be substituted by this num variable's value and num is 5. Sum of sequence number up till 5 is sum. The value of sum will be assigned here, which is 15. So you get the output as sum of sequence number up till 5 is 15. So this is what the output we got. See, sum of sequence number up till 5 is 15. So this is the program. Now you have to find out the smallest of n numbers. Suppose I ask the user how many values are there. The user says I have 5 values. Okay. The first value I am taking and putting it in this hand. This is minval. Now how many values are there? 4. Every value will be compared with the value with this hand. I want the smallest here. The first value, suppose the user entered as 6. Next value, suppose 2. Is 2 smaller than this? Yes. So this smaller value will be kept in this hand. Because in this hand, in this minval variable, I want the smallest value. Next value is 9. I have 2 here. Is 9 smaller than this? No. Discarded. Next value, 1. Is 1 smaller than 2? Yes. So this will be kept over here. So what I am doing is that if the value entered by the user is smaller than the value in minval, the smaller value will be assigned to minval. Let's run it and you understand it practically, huh? See, I am running it. How many values are there? Suppose I enter 5. The first value I entered is 6. Okay. So 6 is assigned to minval variable. Now the for loop will go from 1 till 5. So loop will run from 1 to 4. Okay. 4 times. Because after 5 values, first value is assigned to minval variable, which is 6. The loop will execute for 4 times. Okay. Next value, suppose I enter is 3. 3 is assigned to num variable. Is 3 less than 6? Yes. So this 3 will be assigned to min variable. So min val won't be 6 anymore. This 3 is assigned to min val. Okay. Now I will increment to 2. Suppose I enter 8. 8 is assigned to num variable. Is 8 less than 3? No. So nothing will happen. I is incremented. It will become 3. Suppose I enter 2. 2 is assigned to num variable. Is 2 less than 3? Yes. So that 2 will be assigned to minval variable. So in any case, you are keeping a small value in minval variable only. Okay. Next, the loop will increment to 4. Suppose I enter say 9. See, 9 will be assigned to num variable. Is 9 less than 2? No. So the for loop is over. The minimum value is 2. See, the minimum value is 2. You can convert this program to find out the maximum value from the n numbers. Okay, so do that program and let me know whether you were able to do it in the comment box. Okay, what is this random numbers? See, sometimes you will be asked to make a game of a dice, Ludo. What does the dice do? It gets you the random value between 1 and 6. Right now what I am making is that I am making a program to display you the 10 random numbers between 0 and 9. Let's understand this program first. I am importing a random object, random module. Okay, why? Because there is a method called randint of the random module. What it does, you are providing the range into it. 0 till 9, both are inclusive. So what randint will do, it will get you any random value between 0 and 9, inclusive 9 also. You are printing it. And this for loop will go from 1 to 11. 1 to 11 means this loop will execute for 10 times. And every time, it will get you a random value between 0 and 9. Okay, so let's copy this program. See, 0 and 9 is inclusive. Can you see it here? And the beauty of random numbers is that you will never get the same output every time. See, this 5 is repeated, 7 is repeated again, 5 is repeated again. It is random numbers. See, 9 has appeared. That means this is 9 is inclusive. Unlike a range method, randint gets you the inclusive of these two ranges, right? If I want 50 random values, I have to run this for loop from 1 to 51. You got it? And this is getting you the random values between 0 and 9. There's one more method to get a random value. See, this is choice method. Let's understand this. I'm asking the Python to include the choice method from random module. And what does this choice does? See, I'm nesting a range. Choice does picks up any value between a given range. See, range is between 1 and 10. You can increment to any value, right? So 1 and 10 means between 1 and 9, it will pick up any value and will assign to variable k and it will display it. It will get you only a single value right now. Select it. Paste it. See. Random value is 5. Run it again. Random value is 8. You can get any set, any range here. The choice will pick up any value from the range. It can repeat the same thing when you run it again. You never know. And if I want 10 random values, again you have to write a for loop here. So, this was to find out the random values. This question is to tell you whether the input value entered by user is a prime number or not. See, the logic behind knowing whether the number is a prime number or not, suppose user enters value, say 5. You have to divide the number 5 from 2 till 1 less than 5, up to 4. So if 5 is divisible by 2, 3 and 4, it is no more a prime number. And if it is not divisible by any value from 2 till 1 number less than itself, so that means it is a prime. The number 5 is not divisible by 2, 3 and 4, it is a prime number. And suppose if you enter say 6, from 2 till 5 you could divide the 6, and if the 6 is divisible by any number between 2 to 5, it is no more a prime. Okay, so let's run this. I'm running it. Enter a number. Say I enter 5. 5 is a prime number. How? Let's see. You entered 5. 5 is assigned to num variable. You are making use of a boolean variable prime. Remember, T has to be in capital. Be careful. So prime is a boolean variable which is initialized to true. The for loop will go from 2 till num. Num is 5. So the loop will go 2, 3 and 4. Up till 4 it will stop. Okay. You are dividing 5 by 2. Remainder will be 1. Is val equal to 0? If it is, it will execute this if statement. But it is not. Val is 1. So this statement is not true. After this, the for loop, the value of I will increment. The value of I will become 3. Recall that this is a modulo operator. 5 is divided by 3. Remainder is 2. 2 will be assigned to val variable. Is 2 equal to 0? No. So if block will never run. The value of I will increment. It will become 4. Num, that is 5 divided by 4, remainder is 1, 1 is assigned to val variable, is val equal to 0? No, the value of I is 5 which is not allowed, the control will come over here. Is this logical expression true? Prime is true. So if block will run, num is 5, 5 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number. Okay, now if I run it again, this time if I enter 6, 6 is not a prime number. How? See, prime is defined as a boolean variable which is true. The for loop will go from 2 till 5. The value of I in first round is 2. 6 is divided by 2 and remainder will be assigned to variable val. 6 is completely divisible by 2. The remainder is 0, which will be assigned to val variable. Is val equal to 0? Yes. The boolean variable prime is assigned the value false. Let me again tell you, F should be capital. Huh? It has to be in uppercase. By break statement. Recall from the last lecture that we have understood two statements, break and continue. I assume that you have already seen my last lecture of loops. If you haven't, I am giving you the link in the description box. Please watch that video. Then you will be able to understand this lecture very well. Okay. So by break statement, the for loop will terminate. So the value of I will never become 3, 4 or 5. The for loop is terminated. Control will come over here outside the for loop. If prime is not true. So if this logical expression has been true, if block is executed, otherwise the statement in else block is executed. Because prime has become false, else block is executed, 6 is not a prime number, 6 is not a prime number. Let's run it again. Let's enter some random value, say 127. So 127 is a prime number, okay. Let's enter 165. 165 is not a prime number, it is divisible by 5, okay. So this is the program perfectly running well. Now what is this next program doing? I wanted to explain you the nesting of loops, one loop inside the other. Can you see that for loop is here? Inside this for loop, there is another for loop. Huh? One loop inside another. Here, in this program, I have to explain two things. I have to explain how the nesting of the loop is done. Secondly, I wanted to tell you to display the prime numbers between 1 and 100. So, 1 being the prime number, I have already displayed 1. So, now I have to compare from 2 till 100. Okay. So, value of I is 2 in the first round. Prime variable is initialized to true. For J loop, J loop from 2 till I is 2. See, this for loop will not run at all. Because to make this loop run once, this value I has to at least 3. Because see, loop will terminate on reaching this range. Because I is 2, so the loop is terminated. So control will come over here. Is this logical expression true? Prime is true. Okay, so it will print I. The value I, that is 2, will be displayed. So 1 is displayed, 2 is displayed. Okay, the for loop will increment, it will become 3. Prime is initialized, prime is true. Okay, the for j, it will go from 2 till 3, that means it will run for once. Okay, because the loop will go up till the value of j is less than 3. 2 is already less than 3, so it will go inside it. 3 divided by 2, modulo operator used, remainder is 1. So assign to num variable, is num equal to 0? No. So j will terminate, j has to go up till 2 only, less than 3 only. So it will come over here. Is prime true? Yes. Print I. So 3 is displayed. The value of I will increment to 4. Prime is true. J will go from 2 up to less than 4. That is 3. The value of J is 2 in the first round. I is 4. 4 divided by 2. Remainder is 0. Is num equal to 0? Yes. The boolean variable prime has become false. But break. The for loop will terminate. So it will not execute the if statement. Control will come over here. The value of I will be incremented and then for loop will execute from the next iteration. So the value of I will become 5. So 4 was not displayed. 1, 2, 3. Now 5. So again the value of I will be divided by 2, 3 and 4. If it is divisible, value of prime will become false and the loop is terminated. Nothing will be displayed. If it is not, then it will be displayed. So this is how all the prime values between 1 and 100 are displayed. So let's run this. I am running it and can you see it? See, these are the values. 1, 2, 3, 5 up till 100. Okay. So if you followed this lecture, please subscribe to my channel, share the video with your friends and do write in comments. First let me know whether you were able to write the program for factor of an input number or not. Okay. Do guide me what kind of programs you want me to write on. Thanks for watching the video. Have a nice day.